And take bath in Yamuna, you will never see Yamaraj. There's a one special day in a year that's called Bhai Bhai Dwaj. Dwaj means second day. Bhai means brother. Yamaraj, brother of Yamuna. So 100,000 of people pour, particularly from Gujarat and some part of India, just on that day, take bath in Yamuna. Then see the Yamaraj to make sure they will never see Yamaraj again. That's what still the belief is there. Ye abhi bhi mana jata hai, Yamuna ka darshan karke, Yamaraj ka darshan Mathura mein jo karega, usko kabhi Yamlok nahi jana padega. And Kalindi is one of the principal queens of Krishna. Bhagwan ki aath patriyaniyon mein Kalindi, 1, 2, 3, चौथे नंबर पे रुक्मणी, सत्यभामा, जामवती और फिर जामवती और फिर कालिंदी. सो कालिंदी तट, तट मीन्स किनारा, बैंक ऑफ कालिंदी. कालिंदी तट विपन, विपन मीन्स फॉरेस्ट. So Vrindavan is called Van. Van means forest, and Vrinda means Tulsi. So basically Vrindavan is only one forest, but there are 11 more forests. Total 12 forests. Dwadashakanan. Dwadash means 10 and 2, 12. There are 12 forests, and Krishna walked barefooted in all these forests. Every inch and every particle of dust is so fortunate, they have the touch, sprush of Krishna's lotus feet. Bhagavan ke charno ka braj ke raj raj ne anand liya hai, sprush kiya hai. So what we sing every day, Radha Madhav Kunj Bihari, Gopijan Vallabh Girivaradhari, Yashoda Nandana Brajajana Ranjana Jamuna Tira Vanachai. So in this bhajan, you see Vrindavan. Vrindavan mein kya hai Radha Madhav? Kahan hai? Kunj. Kunj means forest. Vihari means those who are sporting. Vihar karte hai Kunj. Radha Madhav Kunj. Gopijana Vallabh is the Gopijana Vallabh, very dear to the gopis. Girivar Dhari. Dusri cheez kya hai Vrindavan mein? Girivar Dhari. The mountain Govardhan. When Krishna was requested by Brahmaji on the request of Prithvi, Dharti Mata or Brahmaji to appear, so when Krishna decided to come in this world, Krishna only comes one in the day of Brahma, 28th Chaturyugi, and the last part of the Kali Yuga, he only comes himself. Brahma ji ke ek din mein Bhagavan Sri Krishna 28th Chaturyugi ke Dwapur ke ant mein aate. His incarnation comes from Kirodaksha Vishnu, but he himself comes only in one day of Brahma. So, when Krishna decided I am going, then Radharani cannot live without Krishna because they are inseparable. So Krishna said, now you should come also. He said, how can I go where there is no Govardhan, where there is no Yamuna? If there is no Yamuna, if there is no Govardhan, I will not go. Radharani said, Yamuna nahi hogi, Govardhan nahi hoga, to nahi jayenge. So Krishna said, I have already arranged that Yamuna and Govardhan have already appeared in Vrindavan. So Krishna, before appearance, sent the Govardhan and Yamuna in Vrindavan. So Yamuna is coming from Golokdham. So Yamuna, just once, there was a discussion in Agra, Ganga and Jamuna's glories. So Pandits were discussing a lot And this Ganga is most pure because purifying the whole world. Patita Pavani Ganga. Yamuna is also. By darshan you can be purified. So a lot of discussion was going on. Yamuna, Ganga, Yamuna, Ganga. Then they decided to call. It was Rupa Goswami's time or Jiva Goswami, one of the Goswamis. So the Goswami went there, so he said, Ganga is very purifying because it is coming from the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Bhagavan ke charan kamal ko dhoke aati hai, Bhagavan ka charanamrit hai Ganga, therefore it is purified. Everybody Ganga said, Jai Ganga mahi aati hai. Then Goswami said, but Yamuna, in Yamuna every day, Krishna as a whole body was sporting in Yamuna. So Yamuna is more purified. Only lotus feet. Ek to charan dho kya, idhar pura Krishna roz Yamuna mein kood ke nahata hai. Yamuna is glorious. Jai Yamuna Maiya ki Yamuna side, Yamuna Maiya ki jai. Then Goswami paused for a minute and then said, Ganga is also very glorious. In Mayapur, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to play in Ganga every day. So Ganga is also very auspicious. The Ganga and Yamuna are united there. So that way Yamuna is in a spiritual form, Yamuna as a Kalindi is Krishna's queen. So on the both banks of Yamuna there are nice forests and every forest has a name. Mahavan, Madhuvan, Talvan, Lohavan, Belvan, Kamyavan. They are all different names of forests. You can go and find Kartik, our maybe 600-700 devotees, they walk barefoot 1 month to see all these forests. Pyadal chalke, abhi ek mahina Kartik mein, Brajmandal parikrama karenge bhakt. But sab forest mein jayenge. So, un forest mein Krishna kya karte kabhi kabhar. Say once in a while, not every time. Kadachit, sometime he was playing on his flute. Uska instrument kya hai? Flute. There's another instrument Krishna only plays sometime. That is for the Gwal Bal, not for the gopis. There is Shrunga, the harp, buffalo harp. Then he always, in the morning, he blew the horn to invite everybody to come for the morning picnic. And the third thing which Krishna, which he never used in Vrindavan, but the other thing which he used out of Vrindavan was his Panchajanyam sankh, which was to glorify the devotee's victory and to make the demons fearful by the sound of Panchajanyam. So these are the instrument of the different things which Krishna used. Here it means Bansuri. So when he was singing Bansuri, for whom? Muda, Abhira Nari, the cowherd girls, they have given everything. They are the topmost devotees of the Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Aradhyam Brajestanyam Tardham Vrindavanam. If you want to really worship Aradhana, then only the person who is worshipable is Brajestanyam, the son of Nanda Baba, Krishna. Tardham Vrindavanam. And his place Vrindavan is also Aradhya, worshipable. How to worship? Go. Vraja Vadhu Vargena. Kamesha Upasana. How will you do worship? How will you do upasana? Vraja Vadhu Vargena. Like the damsels of the Vrindavan, gopiyon ne jaise Bhagavan ki aradhana ki vaise karna chahiye. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was Pandit, Nimai Pandit, a great scholar who defeated the ग्रेट दिग्विजय पंडित the pandit who has a direct boon from saraswati that nobody can defeat you he was defeating everybody and getting from everybody certificate that he was defeated and somebody said go to navadeep there is a nivai pandit a young boy if you defeat him we all accept you that you are digvijay they reached there mahaprabhu was sitting on the bank of ganga with his students digvijay pandit आया प्रणाम किया एक महाप्रभु गेव यू रेस्पेक्ट इवन विद आई वांट टू हैव डिबेट विद यू महाप्रभु सेड यू आर ग्रेट स्कॉलर आई एम सिंपल स्मॉल चाइल्ड आई डोंट वांट टू सो नो 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 यू मस्ट डू इट सो महाप्रभु सेड देन यू ग्लोरीफाई गंगा सो ही स्टार्टेड ग्लोरीफाइंग गंगा एंड हंड्रेड ऑफ वर्सेस दैट कंटीन्यूअसली वाज सिंगिंग नाइस पोएट्री केशव काश्मीरी नेम वाज Dig means direction, Vijay means conquer. One who have conquered all the direction. In the olden days, the Pandit, they were riding on the top of the elephant with a big umbrella. They are called Digvijay Pandit going. And they were challenging everybody, they come and have a Shastra, earth with us, have a debate on the scripture. And then debate, if somebody is victorious, then the other party has to give in writing. Mahaprabhu said, very nice your poetry. Particularly is in this verse 1. What are the alankar, means what are the beautiful similes and what are some defect? And Kishore said, there's a defect in my poetry? And how you come remember this one verse out of the 100? How you memorize this? Aapko kaise yaad ho gaya? Mahaprabhu said, like you have this power of composing poetry, same God has given me power to shrota, to hear and remember. I am Jyotidat. See, there is no defect in my poetry. Mahaprabhu said, these are nice decoration in your poetry, but very gross defect is you have called Ganga Bhavani Bharatu. Bhavani actually means Durga. Bhava means Shiva and Bhavani means wife of Shiva. And then you say Bhavani Bharatu. It means the wife of Shiva's husband. So wife of Shiva has two husbands. This is defect in your poetry. Bhavani Bharatu. Ganga has descended onto the head of Shiva. That's very nice. But Bhavani means Shiva. Husband of Durga. Then Bharatau means the wife of Shiva's husband. What is who will be the wife of Shiva? Wife of Shiva's husband. Shiva ki patni ka pati. It's a bahut bada gross mistake. Keshav Kashmiri was completely devastated, or the student was laughing. Bada pandit hua tha, itna bada galat tha, to bada blunder ho gaya. He was weeping in front of Saraswati. Saraswati came and said, I told you, you can defeat the human beings, not the Supreme Lord. The next day he came back and go down to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so great, pandit, he was always chanting the name of Radha Gopi, Radha Gopi. This is the highest upasana. So Krishna was playing his nice flute for the pleasure of his greatest devotees, gopis. For their pleasure, Madhu, Muda, to give them pleasure. Abhir Nari, very uneducated girls of Vrindavan. Padhi likhi nahi. Gopiyan padhi likhi nahi. Pandit nahi. They are not pandit. Lekin prem mein pandit hai. They are the pandit in Krishna prem. The greatest devotee and disciple of Braspati. Braspati ka shishya Udhav. The greatest scholar Udhav, the disciple of Braspati, was sent by Krishna to the Vrindavan, to the gopis. to learn the lesson of prem. So Pandit, they are not Pandit in Vedic knowledge, but they are great prem Pandit. Itne bade great Pandit hain. Krishna is saying, Radha, amar guru. My spiritual master is Radharani. Prem Guru, Radha, Amar Prem Guru, Hamara Prem Guru Radha hai. Jaise nachaye vaise main nachta hu. Krishna is Jagat Guru, Bande Krishna Jagat Guru. Aur Krishna kehta hai, mera Guru Radha hai. Mera Guru, Radha, Amara Guru, Prem Guru. So Krishna was giving pleasure to these gopis. And these gopis were giving up everything of this world. Sarvadharman Paritaja, who is the example of this? Gopis. Manmana Mabhavamad Bhakta, who is the example? Gopis. They are the example of Manmana Mabhavamad Bhakta. They are the example of Sarvadharman. जाति का धर्म, कुल का धर्म, समाज का धर्म, निंदा कोई किसी की परवाह नहीं किया. They have given up everything for Krishna. उनको आनंद देने के लिए, what was their desire? How to please Krishna? They were decorating themselves because Krishna will be pleased, not for their personal self. अपने लिए नहीं, Krishna को आनंद देने के लिए they were decorating themselves. So Krishna, this was, Krishna said, na paryaham, na paryaham, I cannot repay you gopis, what you have done for me, I cannot repay. I am indebted you, main aapka ready ho gaya, main aapka ye ready nahi utar sakta, aapne mere liye sab kuch choda, maine kya choda. And Krishna, he said in Bhagavad Gita, he said, ye yatha mam prapadyante tams tatheva bhajamyam. Jo jaise mera charan dekha hai, main vyavahar karta hu. Gopiyon ne sab kuch choda. They have given up everything. When I have reciprocated with them? Krishna was feeling, I have not fulfilled my promise in Golok. So he came as the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he took sannyas. And he has given up everything to repay the gopis. Krishna, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ka sannyas, gopiyon ka ren utarne ke liye. To be free from the debit of the gopis, Krishna came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he took sannyas. The internal reason for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's taking sannyas is to repay the gopis' devotion. Nahi to udhar kaise utregi? He just came for that purpose. He gave up everything. 16 साल की विष्णु प्रिया 24 साल का महाप्रभु सन्यास लेके अकेला माता सची का पुत्र लेकिन घर से निकला सन्यास लेके he has given up everything just to repay the gopis. माता सची जब रोने लगी तो चेतन महाप्रभु ने कहा मां यू आर माय मदर एटर्नली एंड कल यू आल्सो हियर आल्सो यू विल whoever is chanting my holy name you are my mother as a tongue. जीवा के रूप में आप मेरी माँ हो और जो होली नेम लेता है वो तो आपके आपने मुझे जन्म दिया है तो लोगों ने देखा है तो आप you will become tongue and people will chant holy name. There is Sachi Mata, I am your son there and I will appear as a deity and you are my mother as a marble or a stone or metal. आप मेरी माँ मूर्ति के रूप में रहेंगी और आप मेरी माँ जीवा के रूप में रहेंगी एंड आई एम ऑलवेज योर सन. वी आर नेवर सेपरेटेड. सो इन ब्रजवासी गोपियों को आनंद देने के लिए मधुप भंवरे की कहा भंवरे की क्या यू नो मधुप मधुप मीन्स भ्रमर भ्रमर क्या बोलते हैं आप भ्रमर को बंदिशाल बम्बल भी और
बम्बल भी
See, lotus is very soft. Bumblebees goes in the lotus. And tasting the fragrance and rust of lotus in the night, when the kamal closes, the lotus closes, bumblebee is inside. Bumblebee is so strong and expert to make hole in the wood. They can make hole in the wood, but they never perforate the lotus petal. They will die there, never come out. That is called, they are so attached. So lotus feet, or say lotus face of gopis. Gopis face is compared to the lotuses. And Krishna is compared to the bumblebee. Krishna bhavar hai, aur gopiyon ka vadan, chehra, कैसा है? लोटस है. तो लोटस में भंवरा क्या करता है? बंबल भी रस पीता है, लेकिन अपना जान दे देता है. He gives his life. It's not only he is relishing the juice, but he is giving his life. So Krishna, Gopi, Radha Madhava, Kunja Bihari, Gopi Jana Vallabh. तो गोपियों से प्रेम करता है लाइक ए बम्बल बी. बट व्हेन देयर इज ए ट्रबल टू द गोपीज, गोपीज आर इन एंग्जायटी, गिरिवर धारी इज रेडी टू लिफ्ट द माउंटेन टू प्रोटेक्ट हिज डिवोटीज. पहाड़ को उठा लेते हैं भक्तों की रक्षा करने के लिए. सो ही इज भक्त वत्सल एंड गोपीज आर हिज डियर डिवोटीज. सो कृष्णा, this is his first prayer to the Vrindavan, Krishna in Vrindavan. And such a lover of the gopis is glorified by Shiva, Brahma, Indra, Ganesha, and they all are looking, and Lakshmi. They are glorifying Krishna. And that Krishna is now present as Jagannath. So may that Jagannath be visible to my eyes. Let's go to the next verse. Bhuje sai savai venon sirasi sikhi picham kati tate. Bhuje in the hand, sve means left. Left hand mein venu hai. Krishna is having his flute in the left hand. Sirasi sikhi picham kati. और सर के ऊपर ऑन द हेड ही हैज अ पीकॉक फीदर. एंड देन कटी तटे दुकुल, कटी तटे मीन एट द वेस्ट ओवर द हिप्स ही हैज ए सिल्क दुपट्टा. द वर्ड है दुकुलम. दुकुलम का मतलब होता है कपड़ा जिसके दो किनारे होते हैं. दो मतलब दो किनारे, नॉन स्टिच, द क्लॉथ विच हैज टू बॉर्डर्स. दिस क्लॉथ ही टाइड्स एट हिज वेस्ट, कटी तटे. और गोपियों के भी कपड़े जब कृष्ण ने चुराए थे, दुकुल. और एक और सांग है दिलो मंगल ठाकुर का, उस सांग में लिखा है यही वर्ड है. ब्रजे प्रसीदम नवनीत चोरम. ब्रज में, वृंदावन में, द मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट नेम ऑफ द कृष्ण इज नवनीत चोरम, बटर थीफ. Is not only butter thief. Gopanganam dukula choram. Gopanganam means gopis. Dukul means their sari. Dukul means the cloth which has two borders, not a stitch cloth. Sirf sari ko dukul bolte hain. तो ठुकुर चोरम गोपियों की साड़ियां चुरा के गया कृष्ण, पेटीकोट आदि और कुछ नहीं चुराया, ओनली दुकुल है, दुकुल चोरम। और तीसरी लाइन में क्या लिखा है, अनेक जन्म अर्जित पाप चोरम, एंड फॉर द डिवोटीज फॉर मेनी लाइफ टाइम दे हैव ऑल दिस सिन इज स्टीलिंग दोज आल्सो। भक्तों के पापों को चुरा लेता है, गोपियों के वस्त्र को चुरा लेता है और वृद्धवासियों के मक्खन को चुरा लेता है। चोर अगर गण्यम इज द फोरमोस्ट ऑफ द थीफ। श्री राधिकाय हृदय से चोर इज द थीफ ऑफ द थीफ स्टिल द हार्ट ऑफ राधा रानी। राधा से हृदय से चोर, राधा के हृदय की चोरी करता है। नवाम्बुद श्यामल कांति चोरम एंड स्टील दी नवाम्बुद दी क्लाउड रेन क्लाउड, उसके कलर की चोरी करता है, उस जैसा कलर अपना बना लेता है। पदाश्रितं च समस्त चोरम, those who have surrendered to him, unto him, he will take away everything. It's very nice. This is also very nice glorification of Krishna. So, dukula, he has a kamar ke upar Krishna hamesha dupatta bandhta hai, aur us dupatte mein bansuri ko khos ke rakhta hai. He's put his bansuri in there. When he's not playing, either it's in his left hand or he's put it into that tied up dupatta. Then what is the next one? नेत्र अंते, नेत्र ये नेत्र है, ये इसका अंत है, एंड, द एंड ऑफ द नेत्र। सहचरी, सहचरी मीन्स गोपी, सह मीन्स अलोंग विथ, चरी मीन्स विचरण, दोज हु आर वॉकिंग विथ हिम आर प्लेइंग विथ हिम। आंख के कोने से गोपियों को क्या करता है सहचरी, कटाक्ष, दिस कॉल साइड लॉन्ग ग्लांसेस, अंग्रेजी में इसकी ट्रांसलेशन है साइड लॉन्ग ग्लांसेस, गोपियों को कोने से आंख ऐसे देखता है। दिस व्हाट इट मींस, काम को पीछे नहीं, कोने से सिर्फ। और गोपियां कैसे देखती हैं कृष्ण को, हाउ गोपियां सी कृष्ण, वन आय दे कीप ऑन द पेरेंट्स एंड द क्रिटिक्स, इफ दे आर नॉट सीइंग मी विद वन आय दे आर वॉचिंग देयर क्रिटिक्स एंड पेरेंट्स, विद हाफ क्लोज आय दे आर ट्राइंग टू लुक एट कृष्ण एंड देन देयर आर आईलिड्स इट बिकम्स लाइक एंड देन गोपीज बिकम वेरी एंग्री, ब्रह्मा यू डोंट नो how to make eyes, only you gave us two eyes and on the two eyes you have all these lips and half eye we are only using to see Krishna and also it is getting blinding, you are fool, you don't know how to make eyes. So gopiyan aadhi aankh ke kone se keval Krishna ko dekhti hai, puri aankh se to apne nindakon ko dekhti hai. To un gopiyon ki or Krishna apne kone aankh ke kone se एक पूरा अस्तोत्र है, उसका नाम है राधा कृपा कटाक्ष अस्तोत्र, राधा की कृपा का कटाक्ष। और ये अपन थोड़े दिन के बाद दामोदर लीला में पढ़ेंगे, क्या प्रार्थना करता है सत्यव्रत मुनि, कृपा दृष्टि वृष्टि देना बतानो, कृपा दृष्टि इज लाइक कटाक्ष, कृपा की दृष्टि, दृष्टि का मतलब कटाक्ष। तो श्री कृष्ण बांसुरी लेकर, ही हैज ए बांसुरी, ही हैज ए दुपट्टा, ही हैज ए मोर पंख और नेत्र, बाय द एंड, बाय एंड्स ऑफ द सहचरी कटाक्ष विदधते सदा श्रीमद वृंदावन अवस्थी लीला परिचय, ऑलवेज दिस इज ओनली अवेलेबल इन वृंदावन, ये लीला, दिस लीला of Krishna with his dear devotees, gopis and gopas only in Vrindavan. Saghosham nivinjantam, what is the next word? Akhyapayantam. This type of leela, jaise Damodar leela Bhakt Vatsalta ki, aur ye madhur लीला गोपियों के संग में बांसुरी बजाने की रास की, दिस इज ओनली इन वृंदावन, इट इज फॉर हिज ओनली एसोसिएट. Saghosham means his associate. Nimanjana means to drown them. Dubana. Bhaktun ko apne prem mein dubane ke liye, this leela he only does in Vrindavan. This is his Vrindavan special pastimes. So Krishna, with his beautiful loving Sahachari, upon his loving companions, kataksha, sidelong glances, with Radheka, sada, perpetually Sri Vrindavan was the living in Sri Vrindavan. Leela parichwa, such pastimes, is doing this leela only in Vrindavan. Aur kahi nahi karta hai. Jagannath Swami, nayana patgami bhava tumi. So, these two verses, Shankaracharya is glorifying Krishna in Vrindavan. Vrinda in Krishna and Vrindavan is Madhurya Dham. All the pastime of Krishna in Vrindavan are Madhurya. Madhurya means prem. Vatsalya prem, Dasya bhav, Sakha bhav, Madhurya bhav, everything is Vatsalya prem. Where nobody considers Krishna as Bhagavan. Everybody consider Krishna as their own dear darling, son, dear friend, dear master, dear lover, but nothing else. Krishna in Dwarka is Aishwarya Dham. Dwarka Dish is the king of Dwarka. He has many queens. He has ministers. His royal palace, Sudharma Sabha, where Krishna's opulence is manifest. Mayapur is Audharya Dham. Audharya means most merciful, magnanimous, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, papi tapi, no condition. Chant Hare Krishna and get delivered. Audharya Dham. Madhurya Dham, Aishwarya Dham Dwarka, Audharya Dham. Maya. But Jagannath Puri, it is all three at one place. The main Jagannath temple is Dwarka. As you Aishwarya, Chappan Bhog. Every day Chappan Bhog for Jagannath. Bhagavan, Sri Krishna, when he wants to play sport, he comes in Vrindavan. He plays with his coward boys and gopis. When he wants to eat something, he goes to Jagannath Puri. It is always Chappan Bhog ready. And when he wants to sleep, he goes to Srirangam. Soja. All the deities in south are sleeping. Or jab paisa kamana hai, Tirupati jata hai. When he wants to earn money, he goes to Tirupati. Paisa lao. So this is the four different activities Krishna does. Playing Vrindavan, eating Jagannath Puri, sleeping Sri Rangam, and business in Tirupati. Paisa lao. So this is, so Jagannath Puri, as I say, that temple of Jagannath is Aishwarya, Dwarka. Lakshmi is there. Rukmani, Lakshmi. When Jagannath comes out once in a year for 7 days, he goes to the 2 kilometer other temple that is called Sundarachal. The Gundicha temple, Gundicha was the name of the queen of Maharaj. And that place is called Sundarachal. Sundarachal is Vrindavan. Sundarachal is Vrindavan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was going every day to Jagannath temple, but he was cleaning Gundicha temple. It's a Vrindavan. And Gauriya Vaishnava always go every year to clean with broom and water pot, clean everything in Gundicha temple before the Rath Yatra. Gundicha margin. That is, Sundarachal is Vrindavan. Neelachal is Dwarka. एंड वेयर चैतन्य महाप्रभु स्टेट जहां चैतन्य महाप्रभु 18 साल रहे गंभीरा दैट इज उदारे धाम सो जगन्नाथपुरी हैज ऑल थ्री धाम इन वन प्लेस जहां चैतन्य महाप्रभु 18 ईयर्स ही स्टेट इन दैट गंभीरा सो दीज थ्री आर देयर सो नाउ The prayer is now turning from Vrindavan to Jagannath Puri. So third verse is Mahambodhatire Kanaka Ruchire Nila Sikare Mahambodhatire Maha matlab bada Ambodh matlab water, body of water. Tire means at the bank of big ocean. समुद्र के किनारे जगन्नाथपुरी कहाँ है आउट ऑफ द फोर धाम थ्री धाम्स आर एट द मां अम्बुद तीरे द्वारका समुद्र के किनारे समुद्र के अंदर जगन्नाथपुरी समुद्र के किनारे रामेश्वर समुद्र के किनारे ओनली बद्रीनाथ इज हाई अप इन द हिल्स सो थ्री धाम आर एट द Seashore. So Mahambod Tire. Jagannathpuri kaha hai? Mahambod Tire. Hind Mahasagar ke tat ke upar. Ek baar tsunami jaisa ek cyclone aaya tha is pure kshetra mein. Sab jagah paani aaya Jagannathpuri ke chhod ke. Never came there. Sea used to come always in Jagannathpuri. So Hanuman, there's a one Hanuman called Bedi Hanuman. Jagannath Puri is a temple of Bedi Hanuman. Hanuman ko kaha ke samundar ko, you never allow this samundar, this ocean to come in Jagannath Puri, protect this. Hanuman after all cannot stay at one place, he just run away sometime. So he's tied with the chains there now. Therefore he's called Bedi Hanuman. So Hanuman never allows sea to ever enter into the Jagannath Puri. हनुमान अभी जाएंगे तो उधर जो जगन्नाथ में जाए तो बेड़ी हनुमान का मंत्र देखना बेड़ी का मतलब चेन से इज टाइड अप देयर टू प्रोटेक्ट द पुरी फ्रॉम सी तो महाअंबुद तीरे समुद्र के किनारे पे और दूसरी लाइन में क्या लिखा है महाअंबुद तीरे कनक रुचिरे कनक किसको बोलते हैं सोना गोल्ड बहुत गोल्ड रुचि है किसको रुचि किसको बोलते जो बहुत प्यारा लगे रुचि रुचि मीन्स वेरी डियर गोल्डन इफुलजेंस कनक रुचि रे इन दैट व्हिच ग्लोस विद द गोल्डन इफुलजेंस आंखों को भाने वाला चमकता हुआ गोल्ड कनक रुचि रे नील शिखरे टॉप बाय द स्पायर ऑफ बिलू स्पारिस मंदिर जो जगन्नाथ का मंदिर है वो जो अदरी अदरी का मतलब छोटा सा पहाड़ जैसे अदरी धरण भगवान का एक नाम है अदरी धरण गोवर्धन धारी का एक दूसरा नाम है अदरी धरण गोवर्धन को पर्वत कहते हैं तो अदरी हो जाएगा अदरी धरण मतलब गोवर्धन धरण सो नील अदरी ये जो छोटा सा पर्वत है जिसके ऊपर मंदिर है ये इसका नाम है नीलाद्री और इसके ऊपर जो ये मंदिर बना हुआ है शिखर इसका उसके ऊपर जो सोने से चमक रहा है वो दूर से ऐसा लग रहा है कि नीला स्पारी है स्टोन जो होता है जो चमकता है उसके ऊपर गोल्ड इज देयर शाइनिंग सो एट दिस डेड सी देयर इज अ ब्यूटीफुल टेम्पल व्हिच हैज गोल्डन इफुलजेंस And it looks like a blue safari. और उधर कौन है उस टेम्पल में कौन है आप में से बहुत से लोग गए जगन्नाथपुरी टेम्पल इन द इवनिंग सम टाइम यू सिट ऑन द साइड ऑफ द टेम्पल एंड देन देयर इज वन स्पेशल व्हाट यू कॉल This is what is called the word is not coming. Anyway, that word is not coming. The flag, but on the side, on the from when you go from the front on your right side, there's a one place where there's a special panda, and their main business is you have to give money and they will make flag. They are already ready, and then the person will climb up on the way to the top. And this climbing, if you watch, it is a big, astonishing, it is very surprising, a big, the word is like, this is mountain mein trekking karte hai, risk uthate hai, what is that word called? It is an adventure, it is a big adventure. You sit there, wo aise kapde sab bandhega, aur monkey ki tarah aise climb karega ek taraf, then he goes to the other side, then he goes up. And the last part is like this, and then there's a big chain, heavy chain, and he climbs over the chain, and he goes on the top. And then he will put the flag there. And that is more than 200 meter high, 250, I don't know what is exactly, meter high, up there. And then he brings the flag from down there. And then the piece of the flag they give to the devotees, 10 rupees, 20 rupees, 50 rupees. So this is, whoever goes there, they just sit outside and see in the evening, when they are putting the flag up, it is worth seeing. Big adventure hai. Dekha aap logon ne kisi ne? Jo puri guys ko dekha? Dhoja Aarohan ko? It's worth seeing sometime. You will be surprised that man, how he is climbing on the way. Kuch nahi. Seedhi wadi, nothing. And this is a special one full parampara of their coming in parampara. This is their trend like that. Kitna haath ka dhaja chadana hai, how big you want, but 21 haath, 10 haath, really big dhaja they put on the top. So this is there in that temple. Who is there? Vasana. Vasana matlab baithte hai. किस में? पैलेस में. परासादं तो क्या शब्द है? महाम्बोद तीरे कनक रुचिरे नीलस करे वसन प्रसादांत 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 का अर्थ है लार्ज पैलेस. बहुत बड़ा महल है भगवान का, उसमें भगवान रहते हैं. कौन रहता है? किसके साथ रहते हैं? सहज बलभद्रेण बलिना. दी पावरफुल बलराम इज अलॉन्ग विद कृष्णा इन दैट ब्यूटीफुल पैलेस व्हिच इज ऑन द टॉप ऑफ नील अद्री, एंड देयर इज अ गोल्डन इफुलजेंस कमिंग फ्रॉम देयर. सुभद्रा मध्यस्थ एंड सुभद्रा इज इन बिटवीन. एंड व्हाट दे आर, व्हाई दे आर देयर? सकल सुर सेवा अवसर दो. They are giving opportunity of service to all sur. Sur means demigods, those who are endowed with divine qualities. Bhagavad Gita mein ek adhyay 16th chapter is called divine and demonic nature, dev asur sampada. Those people who are endowed with devi sampradaya sampada. This Jagannath is there to give opportunity for them to serve. To bhaktun ki seva ke liye. Aur dusra iska arth hai, devta bhagwan ke seva ke liye aate hai. It is a belief, a day before Jagannath Rath Yatra, Nenutsav, 15 days Jagannath is not giving darshan to anybody. So day before Rath Yatra, everybody rushing there to have a darshan of Jagannath. That night all the demigods, they come down to have darshan of Jagannath. Once Yamaraj was too busy in the office because so many files were there. He came late. When Yamaraj came at Garuda Stambha, there was a small spiral sitting there, Churiya Bethi. यमराज ने चिड़िया की ओर ऐसे देखा, टेढ़ी आंख से, कृष्ण टेढ़ी आंख से गोपियों को देखता है और यमराज ने टेढ़ी आंख से चिड़िया को देखा। चिड़िया डर गई, वेरी फियरफुल। यमराज अंदर भगवान के दर्शन पे गए, इमेजिन साइड। चिड़िया ने गरुड़ को कहा, यमराज दिवे ही सावी व्हेन ही कम आई एम फिनिश्ड, प्लीज सेव मी। गरुड़ इज मर्सीफुल टू द डिवोटीज, स्पाइरल। गरुड़ ने उस चिड़िया को उड़ाया। बहुत फास्ट गरुड़ जाता है, गरुड़ इज वेरी फास्ट, द फास्टेस्ट नोन माइंड, द स्पीड ऑफ माइंड, स्पीड ऑफ गरुड़, वायुदेव एंड हनुमान, दिस फोर आर अनमैचेबल इन स्पीड। सो गरुड़ took the sparrow and he went into the Himalaya, he put into the one cave there and he came running back. वापस आ गया। अब देवता पूजा करके इन फ्रॉम इन साइड यमराज केम आउट आफ्टर वर्शिपिंग एंड ही सा नो स्पायरो बट गरुड़ वाज परस्पायरिंग, लंबा सांस ले रहा है। यमराज सेड व्हाट हैपेंड टू यू, सेड डोंट आस्क मास्टर। यमराज जी आई एम सॉरी, माय डिपेंडेंट स्पायरो वाज वेरी फियरफुल ऑफ यू, I had to go all the way to Himalaya and put in a very small cave to hide her because she was afraid of you. Oh. Yamaraj was saying, my God, hey, Jai Jagannath, Jai Jagannath. He said, when I went to the Jagannath, the last file which I was looking, it was written that this spire has to die in Himalaya in that cave. I was surprised how she will climb, this small sparrow will fly to that place in and I complained to Jagannath, what this is wrongly written there. Jagannath simply smiled. I don't know that you have done the work. So all these sur means demigods, they are coming every day to worship Jagannath. Like Badrinath. it is a firm belief that 6 month Dev Puja, 6 month Manav Puja. For 6 months human beings worship Badrinath and 6 months demigod worship there. Because it's closed, doors are closed, nobody goes there. So Narad is a worshipper of Badrinath and the other demigods go and worship Narad. Narayan is Bhagavan there. He's doing tapasya. So similarly, Sura means demigods, seva, giving opportunity to them for service. And it also means those people who are endowed with divine nature, jinka devi sampada ka gun hai, unki seva ke avasar ke liye Bhagwan ne apne aap ko vahan bithaya hai. Ye tino Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra. Next verse is Kripa Paravaha Sajala Jalada Srine Ruchiro. Kripa Para, kya likhte hain, kya padhte hain, Paravaha, Kripa Paravaha, Kripa ka samundar hai. भगवान जगन्नाथ कैसे हैं, कृपा पारावाह, कृपा के समुद्र है, कृपा पारावाह सजलत, कृपा पारावाह सजल जल, जलदा जलदा बादल को बोलते हैं, क्लाउड, जलदा क्लाउड, सजल जलदा रेन क्लाउड फुल ऑफ वाटर। भगवान श्री कृष्ण कैसे हैं और जगन्नाथ जी कैसे, कृपा के सागर हैं, कृपा के सागर हैं, दया सागर बोलते हैं, कृपा सागर इज अ ओशन ऑफ मर्सी, इट मीन्स अनलिमिटेड मर्सी, मर्सी फॉर एवरीबडी। स सबके लिए उदारता के साथ मर्सी भगवान की है, वो किसी को और कैसे है, सजल जलधर श्रीनी रुचिरो, श्रीनी ए रो ऑफ द क्लाउड रेन क्लाउड्स, कतार में जा रहे हैं, कतार मीन्स ए रो, it's like and cloud is also considered always giving water to the living entities to their life. So Bhagwan ek to daya ke sagar hai aur dusre jal ke bhare hue badlon ke saman ek bahut badi ray mein ruchi ra bahut sundar lagte. His color is very nice, it's like a clouds ray of rain clouds full of water. Rama Vani Rama Spurda Amala Pankeru Mukha. Rama Vani, pleased by hearing the words of Goddess Lakshmi. Rama Vani, Rama Lakshmi ka naam hai. Rama, Bhagwan ka naam hai Ramapati. Rama, Lakshmi, Vani, the words. Rama, Vani, Rama, Vani, Ramaha. Ram ka matlab anand. Rama ki vani mein anand lete hai. Rama, Vani kya kehti hai Lakshmi? Lakshmi ladne ke liye aati hai. Ek ye Rath Yatra mein, there's an episode. One day Lakshmi comes and she chastises all the associates of Jagannath. Why you have taken him to Vrindavan? Kya bolte hai usko? Lakshmi ka? Heera Panchami. Heera Panchami utsav pe Jagannath Rathya aake ek din kisi ko dekha, kisi ne dekha, maarti hai. Lakshmi aake sabhi baal baalon ko maarti hai. Krishna, he has to go to Vrindavan. If he goes alone, then Lakshmi won't allow. He said, I'm going with Subhadra also. Balaram also I'm going. Okay, go. Welcome soon. If he don't come, then Lakshmi comes out. And he chastised all the associates of Krishna, Gwalpal, why you took Krishna? And she's very angry. And then when she says something, Krishna is getting pleasure, Rama Vani Rama, is getting pleasure by the chastising words of Lakshmi. I think the translation is like this. Lord Jagannath is an ocean of mercy and is a beautiful as rose of blackish rain cloud. He is the storehouse of bliss of Lakshmi and Saraswati. The two word hai, Rama. Rama Vani Ramo. Is there another word, another meaning? As somebody has taken, Vani means also words, and Vani also means Saraswati. Rama Vani. So another meaning has taken, because there is different meaning in both. The other meaning has given by different acharyas. He is the fathomless ocean of causeless mercy, and his beautiful complexion is like a cluster of black rain cloud. He drives great pleasure by hearing the words of affectionate chastisement from his beloved goddess Lakshmi. So two angle hai, Rama Vani, Rama means he's getting pleasure by the chastisement of Lakshmi's words, one aspect. The other is, he is getting pleasure from the Lakshmi as well as Saraswati. But practically it looks like chastisement of Lakshmi is more appropriate as per meaning. This meaning is also, you can, Sanskrit you can have some other meaning, but this meaning is more appropriate. Rama Vani Ramaha, and then Rama Vani Ramaha Spurita Amala Pankeru Mukaha. Amala means spotless. No mal. Mal means kachra. Amal means both clean, pure. Pankeru means panka. Punk means actually kichar. Kichar means punk means kichar. And one who is taking birth in punk is called pankaj. Pankaj means one who is born in the. What's called kichar means? Mud. So, who is born in the mud is? Lotus. So, pankeru. Pankeru means the mukha. Pankeru mukha, lotus feet, face. Amala means spotless lotus face. Pankeru mukha. Surendra aradhya shurti. Surendra aradhya shurti gana. Shikha gita charito. Shikha gita charito. Ek taraf Lakshmi, on the one side Lakshmi is chastising. And other side, his view, he is. His face is like fully blown, spotless lotus flower. He is worshipped by the best of demigods and sages. Suchi, Sadashi, Surendra, Aradhya. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Devi worship, hai. Devi. Surendra. Sur means demigods. Devtaon aur rishiyon ke dwara jiski aradhana ki jati hai. Lakshmi chastise karti hai aur devta usko prarthana karte hai. And both are same for him. As we were reading, all devotee offered the flowers to the Krishna and Bhishamdev offered the arrows to the Krishna. For Krishna both are same. The arrows of Bhishamdev Krishna is accepting as flowers offered by the devotee. So Prem se jab maar raha hai, so that is also like flower. So Lakshmi ki chastisement is also pleasing, and when the demigods and the sages, when they glorify, how they glorify? glorified, sung by the topmost person. Gita charita. Which Gita? Shruti. Shruti means Upanishad. Ved. So sages and demigods, a Purusha Sukta, they read the glorification of Lord from the Vedas. And he is chastised on one side by Lakshmi, on the other side, sages are worshipping him with the Vedic hymns. That wonderful Lord, which has two opposite in one. Two opposite things are just under him. If sajal is like a cloud, rain water, sweet water, or ek samundar daya ka hai. Both ways are just, on one side Lakshmi is criticizing. Lakshmi kiski beti hai? Samundar ki. She is born from the churning of milk ocean. Aur Lakshmi ka dusra naam hamare paas kya hai? Paisa. To isliye Lakshmi ka dusra ek naam hai Vishbandhu. Because from the same ocean came the poison. First poison came and then Lakshmi came. So everybody who is intoxicated by the wealth of this world is actually drinking poison. Wo to vish pi raha hai. Unhe vish bandhu hai. Aur vish peene wala jaise pagal ho jata hai, aise dhan se aadmi pagal ho jata hai. To wo Lakshmi chastise karti hai Jagannath ji ko, aur devta aur sages, rishis, they are glorifying Jagannath with the Vedic hymns. That Jagannath, wo Bhagavan Jagannath, hamare upar kripa kare, Jagannath Swami, Nayanapathagami Bhavatame. And then, this is this Jagannath when he is in the temple, these two verses Jagannath glorification in Vrindavan, two verses glorifying Jagannath, Bhagavan Sri Jagannath along with Baladeva and Subhadra in the Jagannath temple. So from Vrindavan we went to the Dwarka. Now Jagannath is going from Dwarka to the Vrindavan again. So glorification of Jagannath now when he is coming out in a Rath Yatra place. So the third verse is this verse. The next verse, fifth is Ratha Rudho Gachan Pati Milita Bhudeva Patlai Stuti Pradhur Bhavan Pratipadam Upakaranya Sadeha Daya Sindhu Bandhu Sagar Jagatam Sindhu Sutaya Jagannatha Swami Nayana Patanami Bhavatume. So this is verse 5. Ratha Arudho. Bhagavan is mounting on the chariot. Ab jo Rath Yatra mein kitne log gaye Jagannath Puri mein at the time of Rath Yatra. The beauty of Jagannath Rath Yatra is to watch when Jagannath is mounting on the chariot. Ratha Arudho. Man Chaitanya Charitamrita is described that how the Lord Jagannath was taken by the Daityapati from within the temple all the way to the Rath. And Jagannath is very heavy. Almost more than 50 Daityapatis. More than 50. They take by the process what is called, they call Pandivijay. They take like this and take from one place to the other place. And over, when Mahaprabhu's time, they used to have big cotton quilts they used to put, and then like big pillows, and Jagannath come, and whole cotton just flies up. The Jagannath is so heavy, uthake ek se dusre ke upar cotton just flies. Now they don't have cotton. Now this cotton is not available. What they do now, in the night, they put a lot of cloth under the lower part of Jagannath as a packing. They do the whole packing from lower part of Jagannath. And then on the head they have big some feather. When Jagannath is coming, the feathers are just lying there. It's swinging like this. And then they take all the way from the temple inside to the gate, come like this. And when they are bringing Ratha Rudho Gachan Pati, when he's ready, at Bhudeva. Bhudeva is called Brahmans. But you will see when the Jagannath is mounting on the chariot, what you see. At that time, all the roofs around the Jagannath temple, they are sold 500 rupees to coupon ticket. But you have to sit only on the roof and watch it. And all these small roofs, minimum 500, maybe 2000 rupees in some roofs, where you get a chair. And you have to go early in the morning, 7 o'clock, with your breakfast, lunch with you, and up till 2 or 3 o'clock, you have to watch everything. So first comes Brahmans with banging their special sounds, they come down and then they do astuti, Bhudeva. These are Bhudeva, they are doing astuti of. And then first comes Balramji, then comes Maya Subhadra, then comes Sudarshan Chakra, then comes Jagannath. When they all are mounted, then comes the Shankaracharya to do the worship. Then comes the king of the Puri, he goes up and with a broom he will make the sweeping. And after that, when it is given okay, then the Rath will start. So this whole process, the Rath Yatra may take 2 hours, but the morning time it will take 4 or 5 hours, Rath Arudho. Just Jagannath going onto the Rath, it takes time. And at that time, Bhudeva, Brahmans are called Bhudev. Bhu means Prithvi. On the Prithvi, the Devta is Brahman. In the heavenly kingdom, the Devta is Indra. Dharti ke upar Devta Brahman hai. Because Krishna is accepting everything through the Brahman's mouth. Because Brahman's mouth is glorifying Krishna by Vedas, therefore Brahman's mouth is the the way to offer something to Krishna. अगर मैं ब्राह्मण के मुख से खाता हूँ, so भूदेव का मतलब ब्राह्मण. So रथ आरूढ़ हो, well जगन्नाथ is mounting on the car, गच्छन पथि प्रेत along the road, पथि मिलित means all the Brahmins are gathered together, assembled. भूदेव, God on the earth, the Brahmins. What are they doing? Astuti. They are doing nice prayers. Prati padam, every step. On Bhagwan, Jagannath is hearing all these prayers and therefore is favorably disposed. Then he becomes very happy. Bhagwan then is saying, how the God become merciful? When Brahmins pray him, then he become merciful. Therefore, who will make God merciful? Brahmins. Therefore, Brahmins are most important. That's what Krishna says. I am pleased by the worship of the Brahmins. Therefore, Brahman are Bhudev. Therefore, the whole purpose of Krishna conscious movement, when Prabhupada started, he said, I am here to train you all as a Brahmins. Because there is a Brahman, then Brahman's action will please Krishna. And when Krishna is pleased, everything is favorable. So to please Krishna, there is a need of Brahman, and Brahman's function is to glorify Krishna. You understand, Prabhupada said that the only way to bring peace in this world is all the radio, television, all this, whatever, if you glorify Krishna, this sound will purify the whole atmosphere. This was Brahmanical culture. If you sometimes go to some places where the Brahmins are chanting the hymns, that atmosphere is very purifying, a very very purifying atmosphere. And but therefore the kirtan, wherever there is a kirtan going on, that place becomes Golok Dham. Jedin ghare kirtan dekhe Golok Bhai. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, when I hear someday in my house when kirtan is going on, I think Vrindavan has descended down. Golok Dham Bhai. That's like a Golok Dham. So these chanting of the hymns by the Brahmins in the glory of Jagannath, Bhagavan, Jagannath become very favorably disposed. Sakal Jagatam, for the whole world, his friend, Bandhu, is very merciful. Daya Sindhu, again. His Daya Sindhu, his Daya ka Sakar hai. Jagatera Bandhu, his friend of everybody. His name is Jagannath. His friend of everybody. Whole world. The first day we discussed, Prabhupada has actually, by his practical preaching, the whole world now knows Jagannath. Now Jagannath is accepted by people all over the world as Jagannath practically. Jagannath, Bhagavan is Jagat ka Nath hai. First time as we discussed day before yesterday, in 67 this beautiful Rath Yatra of Jagannath was first time out of India, in America was celebrated. Now over 100 countries in the year, almost every day there is a Rath Yatra somewhere. So this whole planet has become like a spiritual world. The spread of Rath, Jagannath Rath Yatra is a revolution. It's bringing revolution. In the cities where we have performed these Rath Yatras, it brings a revolution. These people's life, they become jubilant. Rath Yatra is the greatest boon, is one of the activity which somehow or other, we are doing it for purpose of preaching, and somehow Lord Jagannath is merciful and Kali Yuga is ready to bestow his mercy, because devotees are chanting the Bhudev. The devotees are Brahmins, they are Vaishnavas. When they are chanting holy name, Jagannath is very much favorably disposed. He is ready to come out every day. This is something very extraordinary that Jagannath is willing to come out every day. This is the Jagannath and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not different. There is one song also. Jagannath, Sachira Sota Jagannath. What is that? Jai Jai Jagannath Sachira Nanda? Huh? Tibar Tir Bhavana? त्रिभुवन करिजाय चरण वंदन. सो दिस रथ यात्रा विच इस्कॉन इज डूइंग ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड इज जगन्नाथ इन द मूड ऑफ चेतन महाप्रभु. जय जगन्नाथ सचिर नंद. That is the Jagannath in the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is especially Jagannath has followed his pure devotee Prabhupada all the way from Puri to the America in San Francisco. And Prabhupada reciprocated by this glorification of Jagannath every day in some part of the world. It is going on. Like any time, 24 hours in the world, Mangal Aarti is going on. Mangal Aarti, now somewhere in the world there is a Mangal Aarti. Sometimes this is a British, when British was ruling, they said, the sun will never set on British Empire. But it means they have a so big empire, when sun was setting in India, sun was rising in other part of the British Empire. But that was material, it is finished now. But now, sun is never setting on the Mangal Aarti. Everywhere Mangal Aarti is going on in the world. Every time. Abhi bhi kahin Mangal Aarti ho rahi. So abhi bhi kahin na kahin Rath Yatra ho rahi. So this mood in this kind of Rath Yatra is Jagannath Sachirananda. He has given the opportunity for the whole world to do the worship. Sakala Jagata Sindhu Sutaya. Sindhu Sutaya is the name of Lakshmi. Yes, we discussed Sindhu Sutaya. Lakshmi ke saath Jagannath ji. To kaha hoti hai Lakshmi Jagannath ke saath? Kisi ne padha tha, there was one article. How we worship Jagannath if there is no Radharani with Jagannath? Yeah, somebody found that article somewhere? It is in one of the Madhavanand Prabhu's Bindu. In a Bindu. There was one article particularly how Radharani is with Jagannath. Huh? Here it is there, but Jagannath Puri, there is a some system they do and they put Radharani with Jagannath. But now it's possible it's Lakshmi is with Jagannath because now Jagannath is in a Aishwarya Bhav. On the chariot he is in an Aishwarya Bhav. You have heard many stories about Jagannath Rath Yatra. Jagannath Rath Yatra, the eternal pastime of Jagannath. Most merciful Lord coming out to give darshan. Krishna become practically unconscious in Dwarka because of feeling of separation from the Brajvasi and Gopis and Radharani. And now all the Narada came there, Arjun came there, everybody was surrounding the Krishna. What happened? What can we do now for Krishna? Dwarka was a big anxiety, and then Narada said, now there's no other way, you have to take him right now to the Vrindavan. Only when he reaches Vrindavan he will gain his consciousness. Then somebody suggested, so Uddhava, first you go and tell the message to the Brajavasis that Krishna is coming, otherwise Krishna arrives all of a sudden there, achanak Krishna maha pahunch gaye, then they will not really be. So there will be surprise, and surprise is also not. So you go. Uddhava said, I would definitely love to go to Vrindavan. But if I go and tell them Krishna is coming, they will laugh at me. I promised them he never went. Main kehta tha Krishna chalo jao Vrindavan, he never went. So Uddhava declined. Then said, Balaram, you go. Balaram, you go. And tell to the Brajavasi Nanda Baba, Krishna is coming to Dwarka. Say, I love to go. I want to see Nanda Yashoda, I want to see Brajavasis. But if I go and tell them that Krishna is coming there, nobody will believe me. I went there, stayed 2 months. They said, bring Krishna. I told Kanhaiya, go. He never went. Now Subhadra volunteered, I am going. I will go to Vrindavan. I will wipe the tears of Yashoda. I will pacify Nanda Baba. I will make all the gopis and gopa ready to receive Krishna. She said, I am going. So when Subhadra said, I am going, Balaram said, how can I allow my sister to go alone? I will go in the front, but I will never go in first in Vrindavan. She will have to go. So now the chariots came. Tall chariots came with a tall anchor, flag, Balaramji ready to depart. Then came the Subhadra's chariot, behind it started. Then the devotees, they took Krishna, literally, like a drunkard man, they put him on a Daruka's lap, and then chariot started from there to Vrindavan. So these chariots, these three chariots, procession came like this. Internal reasons for teen rath kaise jaate hain, Balaram aage, Subhadra beech mein, aur Jagannath peeche. Now, when they reached there, Subhadra did her job, Balaram was there, Krishna was taken directly to the Seva Kunja. Nidhivan and Seva Kunja, the two places where gopis and Radharani. Radharani was lying there, almost unconscious, very pale. She was just taking some time breath, and all the gopis were sitting around and chanting name of Krishna. And Radharani sometimes opening eyes and saying Krishna, and then again closing eyes. At that time, Krishna was brought there. When Krishna arrived there, he saw Radharani in that condition. Krishna's form became like this Jagannath form. To see Radharani in separation of Krishna, completely pale and closed eyes and almost breathing her last like that, everybody was touching the Radharani's feet and getting a blessing and praying that we have offended you, please forgive us. Krishna arrived, and somebody told in the ear of Radharani, Krishna arrived. Lalita said like this, Radharani opened eyes, and Krishna, he saw Krishna. And that Krishna, in the separation of Radharani, when he saw Radharani, he had this form of Jagannath. So these three cards are coming like this. So this is a special pastime of Sri Krishna in separation of Prajapasis, in separation of the devotees. This pastime is a glory of the devotees, that Krishna become really anxious to see his devotees. Krishna is more devotee conscious than devotee is Krishna conscious. That's what we say. When you chant Hare Krishna, you may not be thinking of Krishna, but Krishna knows you are thinking of him. So this Jagannath form of Krishna, is Krishna is more devotee conscious. He's transformed, his whole body transformed in an excess deep in the separation of Radharani. The next verse says, so Ratharudo Gashanapati, Milit means all are assembled together. Bhudev, Brahmans, Stuti, Pradharva, they are doing prayer, the nice prayers. And what is the result of those prayers? The result of those prayers is Pratipadam. Upakaraniya sadayaha, he become very happy and favorable. Daya Sindhu Bandhu Sakal Jagata Sindhu Sutaya, along with the Lakshmi, the Jagannath, along with Lakshmi become Jagannath Swami Nayanatra Gami Bhavatume. And next verse is Param Brahma Pira Koval Yadolo Kolnayano Utpolnayano Nivasi Niladro Net Charano Ananta Sirshi Rasanandi Radha Sarasa Bapu Alim Ganasuko Jagannath Swami Nayana Patagami Nayana Patagami Bhavatume. Param Brahma Pida Kuvalya Dolo Utpala Nano. So Niladri, who reside at Niladri, Nihata Charano, whose lotus feet are placed Ananta Sir se, jiske charan Anant Bhagavan apne sar ke upar dharan karte hain. Bhagavan Jagannath ke charan Anant se apne sar ke upar dharan karte hain. That's what Ananta Sir se. Rasanandi Radha Saras Vapu Alingan Sukho. Aur aise Bhagavan राधा रानी के आलंग में अनंत सुख लेते हैं। So Radharani is placed on the heart, just in all Vishnu temples. They put the Lakshmi at the chest of Lord Vishnu. Sab South India ke mandiron mein there is a Lakshmi there. They put the Chandan on that Lakshmi, they put Lakshmi there. Is it right?
Yes.
So similarly, Jagannath, Alingan means to the chest. The Radharani is put on the chest of Jagannath. She is always there, and that gives pleasure to Jagannath, because this form of Jagannath is only to meet Radharani. This form of Jagannath is especially, this special form is in separation of Radharani. And this form becomes complete when Radharani and Krishna meets. So, this Rasa Anand, overwhelmed by the flow of loving mellows, Radha Saras Vapu, the Saras Vapu, Vapu means the beautiful form of Radharani. Saras Vapu, Alingan Sukho, who becomes happily embracing. So this Jagannath, even if he is in Jagannath Puri, Radharani is there. We may not be able to see Radharani, but Radharani is there. Like you go to the Radharaman temple, there is no Radharani, but you know, as you call, you don't see, there's no Radharani, practically it's a salagram. But Krishna is nowhere alone, always, wherever there's a Krishna, Radharani is there. So they put the Radharani as a asan there. They put the asan, sometimes they write golden word Radhe, in the name, form of name Radharani is there. So along with Jagannathji, Radharani is there and he's alangan, he is embracing Radharani, and that gives him pleasure. Krishna is never separated from Radharani. Though he is in Niladri, but Radharani is there also. And it's not visible to ordinary people. Like when you go to Jagannath Puri, you see Jagannath in this form. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was watching Jagannath with a love, he was seeing him as a Tribhanga Lalita Shyama Sundara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was seeing Jagannath as a Krishna, Shyama Sundara. To him that form was available, because Radharani, in the bhava of Radharani, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to see Krishna. So Jagannath, he was manifesting as a Shyam Sundara for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But we go there, we don't have that bhava. Therefore, Gauriya Vaishnava, Chaitanya say, we are follower of Radharani, basically. We understand, when we understand Hare Krishna mantra, we are praying to Radharani every day. That please engage us in Krishna's service. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur says, those who worship Vishnu are Vaishnava. Those who worship Krishna are Krishnite. Those who worship Radharani, they are Gauriyas. Gauriyas are worshipper of Radharani. Prabhupada, in the Parvachan, he says, Krishna is controlled by Radharani. If you want really to serve Krishna, then you have to approach Radharani. And you have to approach Radharani, then who is representative of Radharani? Spiritual master is representative of Radharani. So you have to serve Krishna through a spiritual master who is representative of Radharani, and then this thing will reach to the Krishna. Prabhupada said in England, if you have nice flower and you want to offer to the Krishna, don't directly offer to the Krishna. You give it to the Radharani's hand and tell that, please, this you give to your dear Krishna, and then Krishna will accept it. So Radharani is with Jagannath, which is not visible to ordinary people. But here, this verse says, Jagannath, even he is living in Niladri, Nivasi Niladri, but Radharani, Alingan Sukho, he is always having the Alingan, he says, the left side is always Radharani of Krishna. Jagannath. So, because Baladev is there, so Radharani, the Rasa Bhas cannot be physically seen there, but it is within the heart of Krishna, and in Krishna's heart is Radharani, and Radharani's heart is Krishna. There is one pastime in Garga Santa that's called hot milk pastime. First time of 100 years of separation of Radha and Krishna. Radha and Krishna, they had a curse and counter curse by Sri Dhamma and Radharani in Golok Dham. And there was and one curse for Radharani was she will be separated for 100 years from Krishna. And Krishna was in Dwarka, it took 100 years, Radha and Krishna were separate. When they met first time, they met at the place called Bindu Sarovar, at the place called Siddha Ashram, that is in Gujarat right now. We'll go and see that place called Siddha Ashram. So Radharani was taking bath in that Bindu Sarovar. He said, anybody who takes bath in Bindu Sarovar, he will never be separated from Krishna. So when Radharani was taking bath at that time, all the Yadavansi, all the queens of Krishna, they came to the Vinod, that same place, Siddha Ashram. And as soon as Radharani took the dip, somebody came, Krishna is calling you. Krishna is there to meet you. So Radharani received Krishna, he worshipped Krishna, and then queens of Krishna, they met Radharani. Now, it was the time Krishna was in his own, say, palace, little tent, and Rukmani came at night. And he saw Krishna, why you are still not taking rest, still, my dear Krishna? He said, because Radharani is still not sleeping, so how can I sleep? So why she is not sleeping? I just paid everything and I'm just coming from there. He said, she is Viljavasi, she needs a hot cup of milk before she retired. You have not given her milk, so go and give milk. So Rukmani very hurriedly went there. She boiled nice milk and put a nice golden cup and she went to the Radharani. And she was waking her. She was still awake. She gave a cup of milk. And then she came. And she came and she was about to massage the lotus feet of Krishna. She saw on the sole of Krishna's feet blisters. Say, how come this Yadupati, you never went out? How this your foot is burned and there are blisters? Krishna said, Rukmani, you gave Radharani very hot milk. It was too hot. And my lotus feet is in the heart of Radharani. And they are burnt because she drank the hot milk. This is called hot milk first time. So, bahare bhitare, Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Radharani ke outside is Krishna. How is outside Krishna? She is wearing always bilu sari. Radharani wears only bilu sari because Krishna's color is bilu and Krishna wears always yellow dhoti. He has a yellow pitambar because Radharani's color is yellow. So bahare is bilu and inside is also Krishna. Radharani inside is also Krishna and outside is Krishna. Bahare bhitre. Both ways Krishna is there. So they are never separate. They are always together. Radha and Krishna. So this is the next verse is a devotee's bhav. Now this is after the glorification of Krishna as a Jagannath in Vrindavan, Krishna in Vrindavan, Krishna in Jagannath Puri, and again now this is the mood of a devotee. The devotee, he can glorify, but if he want really, he wants Jagannath to be seen, then what is his qualification? His qualification of Navai Yache Rajam, I don't need some big kingdom. Navai Yache Rajam Nacha Kanak Manikyam Vebhavam, neither the gold, Kanak, Manikya, the Hiramoti, what is called, no diamonds or pearls, I don't need anything. Nayache Aham Ramayam Sakalajam Kamayam Varavadum, neither I am interested in a beautiful girls for my enjoyment. Vadu, wife, something like that. This verse look like you, it's like that. Mahaprabhu, this verse, what is that?
Nadanam.
Nadanam, Najanam, Nasundarim, Kavitam, Vajagadishakam. Exactly the same verse. Lagta hai, aise ki nahi lagta hai? Sayache, Rajam, Namanakanaka, Mani. I don't need anything. Na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim. Na sundarim means the third line. Exactly same verse. Bharat is speaking in Ramayana. He is saying same thing. Na chahum gati nirvan. Janam, cham, janam ram pad rati. If anybody remembers that verse, it's a very nice verse, always they recite. Nachahum Pad Nirvan, then the two other words before that. Very nice verse, exactly. Bharat is the greatest devotee, as a devotee of Ram, is a brother. And Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came as a devotee, in the form of devotee, Sri Krishna himself. And they have sung the same verse with the same exact meaning. And this is Shankaracharya, to get the blessing of Jagannath, how can he be visible to you when you have this attitude? And this attitude is called Akanchan Vitaya. The one who don't need anything material and his only wealth is Krishna, that person is called Akanchan. He has nothing. He can get Krishna. So here it says, I don't need Navai Yache. Yache means begging. I'm not begging kingdom. It's not my prarthana. I don't need all these things. What do you need? Sada kale kale pramatpatina gita charito. Sada kale kale, always. This is like janma janmani. Kale kale means whatever the time it is, wherever I am, I only need pramatpatina gita charito. Paramatha Patino by Lord Shiva, the name of Lord Shiva. Bhagavan Pati, nothing like that. Paramatha Patino, the word is given here, by Lord Shiva. Lord of the violent goblins, Bhutpati. Dusra naam Shankar ji ka hai, Bhutpati. Bhutum ka Pati. Geeta Charur Charito, whose glories are sung. I certainly do not pray for kingdom, nor do for gold, rubies or wealth. I do not ask for any excellent, beautiful wife, which is a possession desired by all ordinary men. I simply pray for that Lord of the universe, whose glories are sung by Lord Shiva from age to age. Bhagavan Shankar, jiske gun janam janmantar se, kal kalantar se ga rahe hai. Aise, to Shankar ka naam yahan lene ka kya bhai? While the Lord of Shiva's name is recited here. What is the meaning? Sada kale kale pramath patina. Pramath patina means Lord Shiva. Why is Lord Shiva's name? Because he is the Vaishnava nam yathasambhu. He is the greatest Vaishnava. He knows the truth about Supreme Lord. And he always speaks the glories of Krishna. And his teaching is Aradhanam Sarvesham Vishnu Aradhanam Param. And Partaram, and greater than Tadiya, their devotees. So that mood, because the word Radha is there, the greatest devotee of Krishna is Radha. By their mercy, and now this Lord Shiva is another greater devotee. So you go to the Krishna, you don't ask anything, you ask the mercy of devotee. It is the devotee's mercy which will only enable us to reach to the Krishna. There is no other way, no other way, no other way, only by the mercy of devotee. So this is Sada Kale Kale Pramathapatina Gita Charito. So from time immemorial, Lord Shiva is also eternal. He is always glorifying the glories of Lord Krishna, and Shiva is one who is fitting into this category. He is not needing any kingdom. He don't have a palace. He don't have a house still today. Lord Shiva once, Parvati said, how can we live all the time under the tree? Make some house, Baba. Bole Baba, house, banao house. Anyway, Parvati, she has everything. She made a beautiful house. Now a good palace is ready for Lord Shankar to enter. Parvati and Shankar enter. They said, Lord, call Brahman. Let us do how grave parvesh. We enter in the house. So Brahman came and they did the big yagya. When yagya was over, Brahman said, Bole Baba, Dakshina. Brahman said, Dakshina? कुर्ता आई डोंट वियर एनीथिंग मैं वागम पर आई एम वियरिंग ओनली दिस स्किन ऑफ टाइगर आई डोंट हैव अ बैग बट देयर इज नो चेन बट दक्षिणा यूनिट यूनिट दक्षिणा ओके आई एम गिविंग यू दिस हाउस इन दक्षिणा he made this house and then he gave this house in the one of the name of Lord Shankar is Aniketa. Aniketa means he has no personal house. And in Bhagavad Gita 12th chapter, Krishna is describing Aniketa Niketa Bhaktiman Priyosi Me Nara. The devotee who has no personal house is very, very dear to me. So all the devotees living in Varuna are dear to Krishna because they don't have a personal house. They are Aniketa. Aniketa, Lord Shiva is Aniketa. Because this is the mood of Lord Shiva. He don't need anything. He don't have anything. Because he has Krishna. Because he has Krishna, his wealth is Krishna. He's glorifying Krishna. So what he need anything? He don't need anything. And people go to him and ask him, give us something. He said, I don't have, what can I give you? The people are fool or not? Baba, हमारे को घर बना दे बाबा बोलते हमने अपना नहीं बनाया अभी तक तुम्हारा कैसे बनाया बनाएगा people go and pray to the Shiva to get something and he said I don't have Baba you ask me I have you ask me that I will give you and what you have I have Ram now you want that I will give you so this is the first part of the verse is saying devotee don't need anything and who is that devotee Lord Shiva is that devotee Vaishnavanam Sanat Samu. He is that devotee who don't need anything and therefore he is glorifying all the time Bhagavan Jagannath and therefore Jagannath is very happy. And then last verse are Haratvam Samsaram. Now he is praying. Now he has put Lord Shiva as a what is called advocate for you. Because by his mercy if you can be by Radharani's mercy, by his other devotees' mercy, now he is begging himself something. This is a procedure to approach the Supreme Lord. First glorify him. Then glorify his devotees. Then ask for some benediction. Seedha jaake Bhagwan ko aise chitti nahi dena hamara ye kaam karo. No. This is a procedure. The standard procedure is glorify Krishna, glorify his devotees. He will be more pleased when you glorify the devotees. Now we have glorified Lord Shiva. We have glorified Radharani. Now he is asking him something for it. Haratvam Sansaram, please take away my Sansar means birth and death. Please relieve me from birth and death, from all this misery of material world. Sansar means material world, birth and death. Haratvam Sansaram Durtaram Asaram. Durtaram Asaram. This is Asar. Asar means there's nothing sar in this. It is all temporary. What we think it is mine, it is not really last. No, asaram is useless. Haratvam sansaram durtaram asaram surpate. You are the surpate means you are the master of the demigods. The next verse is Haratvam papanam vidatam aparam vidadate. I have unlimited sins. Please take away all those. Please. So this is the prayer in the last. Seven verses, first four verses, two verses, Vrindavan glory. Next two verses, glories in Jagannath Puri. Then the other two verses, devotee of Krishna, devotee of Jagannath, then Radharani. Same procedure you will find in Damodarashtakam. Krishna's glories, then comes to the deliverance of Nalkubera and Manigiri. Narad's glory, because of Narad that happened, and then he has to say Satyavartmane Namo Radhikaya Tvadiya Priyaya. When he said that, then he said, now I beg you, be merciful, because this is the way to pray. Now he said, Haratvam Papanam Vidatam Aparam Apar Yadavpati. He Yadavpati, he Krishna, he Jagannath. Haratvam papanam vitatam aparam, unlimited from many lifetimes I might have done sinful activities. प्लीज नाउ यू टेक अवे ऑल दिस, क्लियरिफाई ऑल दिस. जगन्नाथ स्वामी नयन पद स्वामी जगन्नाथ अष्टकम पुण्यम ये पठेत प्रियंस पुण्यत सुचि ही सर्व पाप विशुद्ध आत्मा विष्णु लोकम सगच्छति. सो दिस इज द लास्ट वर्स. थैंक यू वेरी मच टू Murli Prabhuji and his devotees to give us opportunity to serve you. And if you read really it again and again and master the meaning, then when you sing, you can feel it. When you feel it, then there will be desired result. And you learn how to pray. This is the last translation in this. O Lord of the demigod, please quickly take away this useless material existence that I am undergoing. Janamirtyu. O Lord of the Yadus, please destroy the boundless accumulation of my sinful reaction. Oh, it is certain that Lord Jagannath bestows his lotus feet upon those who feel themselves humbled and helpless. Humbled and helpless, may that Lord Jagannath kindly become visible unto me. The third line we have not read, huh? Aho Dina Nath Nihit Charito Charano. Aho Dina Nath. You are Dina Nath. You are the friend of the humble people. Deen means humble. Deen doesn't mean the Jhupat Patti wala. Deen Jhupat Patti wala nahi hai. Kuch nahi hai, wo Deen nahi. Deen means humble. The humble. Aho Dina Nath Nihit निहित चरणों, निहित चरणों, whose feet are bestowed, निहित चरणों, निश्चितम, I am certain you will bestow your mercy. I know your lotus feet are always available to give protection to those who are humble and meek and sincere. Humble and helpless. Also in Jagannath Ashtam, similar words are there. What are those words? But in Jagannath Ashtam, or in the Damodar Ashtam, same words are there. Deenam Batanam. I am very deen. I am very helpless and humble. Deenam Batanam. Kripa Vrishti Drishti Deenam Batanam. So far, two more days there we will discuss Damodar Ashtak along with ninth chapter of Bhagavatam, Damodar Leela and Damodar Ashtak both together for 3-4 classes and buried Balam in this temple. We will do it. We request please relish Krishna's pastime. This will bring auspiciousness in our life. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki
jai.
Jagannath Balaram Subhadra ki
jai.
Hare Krishna.